Hello beautiful, strong, happy and healthy people. You may have seen I just released a video talking about 6 of my top tips to help you get into reading. If you're the type of person that, like me, that's really not a fan of reading but really wish they could be a bookworm and really get into it like other people can. So this year I set myself a challenge on reading a book a month, and so far I've committed really well to that challenge. I'm pretty proud of myself. So I want to give you guys a sneak peek on the, what are we up to, month 5? Almost month 6? The 6 books that I have read slash in the middle of reading so far this year, and a little bit of a sneak peek at my bookshelf. The first book I started my book challenge off with is The Supple Art of Not Giving a Fuck. This book is really good. It's a self-help book, and it's a really good book for our generation that really don't mind using the word fuck a lot and need that little bit of an extra push. This book was a really easy read and a great way to start. There's actually not a lot of pages, and the text and the font was actually quite sizable. And I read this pretty much within a week and a half. So a good way to start the challenge. Book number 2, I went straight in and went for one of the biggest books I could find. I read this in about a month. It's a bit of a challenge considering how big it was. I'm not a big fan of reading, but I really love this. And this was The Tribe of Mentors by Tim Ferriss. Now, I'm a big fan of Tim Ferriss books. Okay. I've listened to his books, haven't necessarily read them. Big fan of listening to Tim Ferriss's books and podcasts. But the cool thing about this book, it is a question and answer based book. So it's interviews with about 100 different entrepreneurs and influencers. And it is just super basic, really easy to consume. There's 11 questions that he asks different people. So short life advice from entrepreneurs and business people and athletes. So it's really, really cool, really easy to read. Even just skimming through this book, you find someone that you really love and you can find their name on here and see the answers to the questions. So the thing that got me a lot in this book was that he asked the question to people that what book has influenced their life or what book have they given most as a gift. And because of that, it recommended so many other books on top of that. So I now have a list of about 50 books that I need to pick up and read after reading this book. Book number 3 was Jordan Peterson's 12 Rules for Life. Now this book was a little bit of a heavy reading. It was quite religious. There was a lot of Bible text. I did love it at this. This book was good, but it was a little bit harder for someone that, like myself, that's really just getting started into reading. But I did watch a lot of his content online, and he has a lot of awesome book summaries that pretty much sums up all the main points in the book already online. So even if you're not really into reading, it is a really good, like, there's a lot of really good content that you should check out on his blogs and on his keynote speeches about the book. Now with all the reading, I thought I'd mix it up a little bit, and I wanted to try something that was a little bit more interesting, a little bit more storytelling. So I wanted to go for a fiction book. In the cinema there was a movie, Ready Player One, and the Marvel said the movie was awesome, so I decided to give the book a quick read before I go out and watch the movie. This book was actually a pretty easy read, and it was a really well written, really grasped you. But the problem is, my brother's like, if you read about half of it, you can go watch the movie and you get the gist. So I read probably about 2/3 of it, went and watched the movie. The movie was totally different to the book, and it made me a little bit angry. Obviously, it's just how it is, books and movies. So I came back home and I finished the whole book that weekend so I could see how this ended, because there were two completely different stories. So you cannot just read half a book and go watch a movie and expect to get the gist, because it does not work that way. But movie and book were a pretty awesome combination. Next book I read 2 books in 1 month, and one of them was The Barefoot Investor. This is a book that I got recommended so many times, and if you're an Australian, this is a must read, especially anyone that is any age. But if you're young and you're not reading it, you really need to. You can pick this book up from Kmart for about $20. A lot of people ask if they can borrow my copy, but I say no, because it is full of tabs. And it's full of information that I'm going to refer back to one day and that I need to kind of keep for myself. So it is a book that does become quite personal to you, because you do make marks, and it is an actionable book. So you will read a small chunk of it, and then you go away for a week or two, and then you will take what he suggests into action, and then you'll come back and then you'll finish up the book later. Book number 6 is obviously Crushing It, Gary Vee's second book. I read the first book, Crush It, a while ago. Took most of the things into action, obviously not everything that I needed to do, which is why I go and read the second book, even though he says exactly what I need to know in the first one. The second one really puts things into perspective and really makes you put it into play. Anyone that's interested in internet marketing, social media, building a brand, getting into online content, or building a business really needs to check out both of his books. And book number six that I'm on right now is Sapiens. When I was reading Tribe of Mentors, this was actually the most recommended book that I came across quite a bit. Entrepreneurs, business people, elites, everyone suggested this bad boy. This is about human evolution. It says on the front, what Bill Gates says is that I recommend Sapiens to anyone who's interested in the history and the future of our species. So it pretty much explains how it came about, and it's a really, really awesome read. There's a couple points on there that makes a lot of sense based on the why humans are born premature, why our heads are shaped differently, why we're tribal culture, why we're tribal tribal animals, things like that. So it's a really, really cool, interesting read. Now, because of that, my second read, which I've already pre-bought, is going to be the Homo Deus. That's how I say it. The second book of Sapiens. So they're quite sizable reads, but I gotta make sure I finish this one within the month. The month hasn't even started and I'm already a chunk-ish through. So they are my six books that I've read so far this year, and the ones that I'm continuing to read the next few months. I've got quite a few more months of the year, but I want to keep this one book a month thing going. There's a couple other books that I have in my bookshelf that I will share with you. Now, I have not fully finished reading this one because it is a book that you pick up, you read a little bit, and you kind of process it and you think about it. So I pick this one up every once in a while and give it a bit of a read, and that is The Art of War. And this book, the copy that I have, is absolutely gorgeous. And the way it's set out is beautifully illustrated. So I absolutely love this book. But I haven't fully finished reading this yet. So this is on one of my to complete lists. The other book I have is Tony Robbins' Money Mastering the Game. This is all about compound interest. This is a really, really interesting read. It's probably better for people a little bit older, whereas I recommend people like 25 and under to really get into the Barefoot Investor book. Obviously, crushing it, Gary Vee's first book, is a must have for anyone wanting to be their own boss, entrepreneur, or build any type of brand or business online. And then I've also got Sex of Dawn, which is a book I read last year. Things that question their human evolution, sexuality, monogamy, polygamous relationships, etc., etc., etc. This was a really, really interesting read as well. And then I've just got a bunch of random books that I've got on my to-do list, like Freakonomics. Now I go to the bookshop and I see some awesome little books and I'm like, I want to read that. So I buy it. So these are all ones that will be added into my reading list this year. So thank you guys so much for checking out my video. If you have any books that I really need to get my hands on and I need to read, then please let me know in the comments below. That's a little bit of a sneak peek at the six books that I've read so far this year, and a couple more that I'm going to make sure I hit by the end of the year. But if anything I'm missing, anything I really need to get my hands on, then let me know. In the meantime, keep being strong, happy, and healthy.